Hey, this is Tom Barber, Extension Weed Scientist with the University of Arkansas System Division of Agriculture. I'm down at Tiller, Arkansas today evaluating some of our corn herbicide trials. And we really appreciate the support from the Corn Promotion Board program that allows us to evaluate these different systems trials to see pretty much what the best bang for the buck is from a weed control standpoint. Now, most growers in the state want to get the weed control done in one application, and that's very difficult. So what we've done in this particular set of experiments is we've looked at one-shot programs and how they compare either all up front or all early post. One of the things that we wanted to look at in these weed control plots is our grass control, because our counterparts across the river in Tennessee have identified glyphosate resistant barnyard grass. So it's important to know what that might mean for our corn producers moving forward were we to get into that situation. So as usual, we have our untreated checks randomly throughout the experiment. The majority of the weeds in this test is either going to be pigweed or a grass species. We've got three different grass species out here. We've got broadleaf signal grass, we've got barnyard grass, and we've got a little southwestern cup grass. And so we're looking at these systems either pre and post to determine which one is the best system if we're going to try to get by with one application. And because we're treating it like we have some glyphosate resistance in our grass population, we're not using any Roundup in this experiment. So we just wanted to compare the mixtures and how well they do without Roundup. And so again, I looked at several different herbicide combinations all at once up front or all post. And the first plot I want to show you kind of sets a baseline, because our general recommendation in corn production in Arkansas is always go out with something up front. And a lot of times that's S-metolachlor or dual 2-magnum. And so obviously this corn is fairly old. I believe it's been 6 weeks since we've planted this corn and sprayed the dual magnum pre at a pint and a third. But you can see it's pretty much lost all of its control. We've got pigweed, we've got grasses, we got everything that we have in our untreated checks is coming out in this plot, including some morning glory. And so if we're talking about a one-shot program, dual 2-magnum is not going to carry us through the season. We need multiple products. And so if we turn our attention to the next plot, we'll see what that looks at, and we'll look at multiple different mixtures of herbicides to compare to just dual by itself. We just looked at dual magnum applied at planting, and that's all that last plot had, and we saw how that herbicide has broke, and we have a lot of weeds germinated and emerged in that system with just dual. The next thing I want to show you is Corvus plus atrazine plus Warrant. And so when we mix three products like that together, we're going to get more of a broad spectrum control, and this is one of the typical Bayer programs that they promote in the state for corn production. So this is one application at planting of Corvus, Warrant, and 2 quarts of atrazine. And it is a fairly clean plot. We have some grass coming up. In general, when I rate Corvus plots, the grass is the first to break. Warrant is probably not as strong a grasser as dual 2-magnum, but most of these species we have in here is nut grass, okay? And so none of those work on that very good. We've got some barnyard grass coming up right there and some broadleaf signal grass on the edges. And so it's starting to break. It's not near as big of species or near as big of weeds in this plot as it was the dual by itself. So we've got a broader spectrum of control, but we're still not going to carry all season just putting it out pre-emerge, not even with those three products. We're talking about single applications, pre-only applications, and the next one we're going to look at is Verdict and atrazine. So this is 2 quarts of atrazine and 10 ounces of Verdict. And really the only thing left in these plots, and again, these are 6 weeks old, is the grass that you start to see coming up. And so fairly clean plot, but we've got some escapes. Looks like broadleaf signal grass and a little bit of barnyard grass. The only thing we did in this plot at planting was add Zidua to the Verdict and atrazine. And what it's done is it's extended some of that residual control on some of the grasses that we had escaped in the last plot. So 10 ounces of Verdict, 2 quarts of atrazine, and 4 ounces of liquid Zidua or Zidua SC, and we've still got a pretty clean plot 6 weeks after application. The next one we're going to look at is a very simple program. It's a pint and a third of dual 2-magnum plus 2 quarts of atrazine. It's economical. It provides decent weed control, but at 6 weeks you can tell we've got some escapes. not near as clean as the plots we've been looking at with three herbicide modes of action up front. All right, as we stated at the beginning of looking at these different plots, we're looking at one-shot programs, and we really were focusing on grass control. Obviously, we're gonna look at the broadleaf control that we have, but in a situation where Roundup may not work anymore, especially on some of our grasses like barnyard grass. So this particular plot is Steadfast plus atrazine. And a couple of things you'll note, so this is 2 quarts of atrazine plus 1.5 ounces of Steadfast Q. And one thing you'll see right off the bat is we've got some injury on this corn. And a lot of that injury we're attributing to the fact that the corn may have been a little too big because of the rains and how they fell this year. We didn't get our applications timely. And that happens to a lot of producers, that's real world. But where we see the mixture in Steadfast Q, we're seeing more injury than we're seeing with some of the Accent Q plots I'll show here in a minute. But for a general weed control standpoint, it did much better than I could ever expect with just Steadfast and 2 quarts of atrazine. Obviously we had some pigweed up front there and in the back that were too big. But when we're talking about grass control, excellent grass control activity out of the Steadfast Q. Just always remember your growth stage restrictions for Steadfast Q, and if you go a little over, you can see some injury. We also have some corn hybrids that are more sensitive to ALS herbicides, which Steadfast Q is an ALS herbicide, and you can see some similar injury to this on those corn hybrids. We're out here looking at total post programs for grass and pigweed control. Again, we're focused on grass a lot in this particular project, just in case we lose Roundup in some of our grasses to a resistance. And so we look at this particular plot. This is Shield X, which is a fairly new HPPD herbicide that is registered in corn. Shield X plus 2 quarts of atrazine. Again, we got excellent control of our broadleaves. All this had was one application on it 3 weeks ago. We got excellent control of our broadleaves, but some of our grasses have come back and we didn't get good coverage maybe, but we've got, because of all the weeds present, but we've got a lot of barnyard grass, broadleaf signal grass, and some southwestern cup grass in this plot. We also have some nutsedge, but we didn't expect much control with the nutsedge, yellow nutsedge from that treatment. But again, it just shows how important Roundup can be in a total post system if we don't have a good grasser in the mix with that. The next total post we're gonna look at is Armazon Pro at 16 ounces plus 2 quarts of atrazine. And overall, I'm very pleased with the control in this plot, especially compared to our untreated check next door. We had excellent weed control overall, but again, we're leaving some of these grasses, and it just goes to show the importance of having Roundup in that post-emergence tank mix to take care of those grasses. And so in the absence of Roundup, we've looked at Steadfast Q earlier. Nothing is quite as effective on grasses as some of the ALS herbicides, such as Accent Q or Steadfast Q. Next total post we're gonna look at is Realm Q plus 2 quarts of atrazine. And again, much like we saw in Armazon Pro, this one didn't quite give us as good a grass control with the Realm Q, which has Callisto and Rimsulfuron in it. Here in a minute, we'll look at Accent Q, which seems to be a little better on some of the grass species that we have here. But again, what we're seeing is escape grasses from that one post-emergence application, Realm Q plus atrazine. The next total post we're gonna look at is a fairly new herbicide from Syngenta called Acuron XR. It has two HPPDs, one being Callisto, one being Bicyclopyrone, and then it also has dual 2 Magnum, as well as a little bit of atrazine in it. And then we added more atrazine, so we have 96 ounces of Acuron XR plus 24 more ounces of atrazine, which gives us our 2 quarts. And when we look down through here, again, for a total post program, a very good control of grasses and broadleaves. We have some vines here that are left, honey vine milkweed, and then maybe a little red vine right there, and some yellow nutsedge. But you can see, and some of this is bleached out, and that's that HPPD working right there on some of that. Pretty clean plot for a one-shot program, Acuron XR plus atrazine. So one of the last over-the-top total post programs we're gonna look at today is Accent Q and atrazine. Accent Q at 0.9 ounces and 2 quarts of atrazine. And when I look at this plot, what I have left, I've got a lot of yellow nutsedge that we didn't expect to get with that herbicide, either of those herbicides. I also have a few grasses that that are still here, even though Accent Q has really good activity on grasses. It's not near as clean as a plot where we had Steadfast Q out for our grass material. And so although Accent Q and atrazine look pretty good here, and we've probably rescued this crop from any more yield loss due to weed control, we still are gonna have a lot of weeds to deal with throughout the season and by harvest, and they'll seed out and cause us more problems next year. So just to wrap up, some key basics, corn weed control. You know, pigweed's a big issue for us, morning glories, and then grasses. And grasses can become much bigger of an issue if we run into some glyphosate-resistant barnyard grass like they're seeing in Tennessee. And so what we recommend is always going out with multiple residual herbicides. Generally, we like going out up front with either Dual or Verdict or something at planting to give buy some time to get a total post, or not our total post, but our post application out, which again expands our residual activity and gives us a little longer length of residual altogether. But from our pre-programs, three products mixed together, a lot of times we're still clean at 6 weeks. Now we'll see how that plays out through the end of the season, but if you wait and do that to a total post, a lot of times you're going to have some misses, and it could be due to coverage, could be due to size of the weeds and just the sheer weed spectrum that's there by the time you get around to your total post application. So again, in my opinion, putting it all out up front is better than putting it all out post. But overall, to minimize your pressure early season and late season, a two-shot program is going to be best for us in our corn production system.